Are you a bear or are you a bull? Today, magbibigay tayo ng mabilisang update on what happened for this week. Alam naman natin ang Bitcoin ngayon and the rest of the market are in the sideways. But let's see ano ang mga interpretations natin when it comes to the fundamentals of the news and some technical chart analysis that will help us.
This is Healthy Minds giving you bites and pieces of crypto news.
So today we'll be including Glassnode's indicators that will show us ano ba ang status ng Bitcoin sa exchange. Are we actually increasing or decreasing? Also, pag-usapan din natin ang surprise ng Binance US and who will be the next CEO for them. Speaking of that, today we'll try also to check Coinbase on what happened to their listing. Plus, additional things that might affect the market, like the Middle East's first Bitcoin funds. So with that, I'd like to give a shout out to Sir Dugs and to Sir Migs for giving their comments. They are actually asking if it's possible for us to check Pancake and some other things that we could do on our platform. Encouraging you guys to check that comment box down below. See and which one do you like us to add on our daily and weekly updates, and we could relay back to our community page, Digital Healthy Minds, or you could join our group to talk about, and perhaps I will showcase some graphs there and technical analysis when it comes to this token or coins that you wish to talk about. So kagaya na napag-usapan natin, let's begin with CoinGecko and check the total market cap. We could see here that we're back 2 trillion plus, and Bitcoin is just down by 0.3%. So we're just running in sideways for 55,000 plus for quite some time now. Ethereum is back on 2,300 plus, Binance at $584.83. We got also XRP at the number 4 slot. Then followed by Tether, Dogecoin on the number 6 slot, and so on and so forth. But we also have here Cardano at 1.24, Polkadot at 34.51. What else do we have here? Looks like the market is actually neutral. So with that, let's just continue and see what is actually the headlines and the latest in the crypto world. Coinbase direct listing successfully done through NASDAQ. So what happened here? As we know, the above reference price was $250 published late Tuesday by NASDAQ. But at around 1:04 p.m. Eastern time, it was indicated that the trading started at $380. So from then on, this is the current status of Coinbase share running around $300+. So it's been a while that we push up, and right now we're running on the sideways. In parallel with that Coinbase news, we have here Binance. US hires former bank regulator Brian Brooks as the CEO. We know that Brian was the Trump's administration acting controller of the currency, now joined the US affiliate for Binance. Brian Brooks was also a former Coinbase executive who helmed the office of the controller of the currency under the US President Donald Trump. So after stepping down from the public last January 2021, crypto observers have been watching closely for where Brooks would land. And in March, he joined the board and data sharing startup Trinks Labs. The Binance US move is clearly far more significant. As we know, last time I actually shared, CC posted on his Twitter account saying to Coinbase, "Congratulations, you take care of Wall Street. But on the other hand, we will take care of all the street." So there's a good competition in the market. And we can see now this is really something in the news. Let's look forward more with regards to Binance. This guy, Mr. Brian, as we know, has a good connection when it comes to US expand. Meanwhile, in the Middle East, it is set to see that the first Bitcoin funds mentioned that the 3IQ, the Canadian Digital Assets Management Funds, has gained authorization from Dubai Finance Services authority to list the first Bitcoin-based fund in the Middle East. Adding on that, the fund will be listing on the Nasdaq Dubai and expected to be listed this quarter. Even Middle East are participating now with cryptocurrency, particularly with Bitcoin. Now, when it comes to the indicators, I'd like to show what's going on with the Bitcoin dominance. Looks like it's continued to plummet here, and somehow we are finding temporary support around the 50 points range. We are now on the critical level that if this will continue to move and break this resistance, then this is going to be expected an alt hyper bullish movement. But for this one, we might have a little bit of bounce here, testing the previous support. Now might act as resistance before it continues to go down. But of course, this will all depends on the market. If this will break, definitely we could expect that the alt season will be hyperbolic. And speaking of that, let's see what does the Atom market tell us, because it seems like on Glassnode, we could clearly see here that the distribution of Bitcoin is going down on exchange. And what does it mean? For the past 2 years since we actually had this one, we could see now that this was the lowest from 2018. It breaks now below the 2.4 million BTC that are in the exchange. So it only means that this is actually a bullish news in the market, pulling all the BTC out of the exchange for long holders. So I'm just gonna ask you again, guys, besides this price action that we are all experiencing, are you a bullish or are you a bearish? As for me, it's good for us to buy the dip. But again, I'm not a financial advisor, so always do your own diligence. But this one looks very healthy as the behavior of the markets go sideways on Bitcoin. For sure, altcoins will run up for a big move. Once again, thank you and ciao.
Once again, this is Healthy Minds reminding you that you're not a financial advisor, so always validate and do your own diligence.
So are you a bear or are you a bull? Please don't get me wrong. The market has still rooms from the downside, although when you check the macro indicators, especially when it comes to Plan B and Glassnode, we could see that Bitcoin has the lowest value on the exchange for the past 2 years. So what does it mean? Anong ibig sabihin nito sa market? Well, though the price of the Bitcoin in a sideways action, and for the past few days, we experienced this correction and downward action. Looks like the institutions are continuously holding and buying and digging this asset going to cold wallets or out of exchange. Checking the fundamentals a bit, it seems like we still have a long way to go on this bull market. And as we know, just like what I explained before, if Bitcoin will continue to run in a sideways, we could expect that altcoins will explode to the upside. We could observe now what will happen to the next few hours and days. But if the case that Bitcoin will plummet, well, we could expect the alts will continue to move down.